I like that one too. Welcome back to Investing with Confidence. As always, I am your host, Joshua David. And if you're just tuning in, we were talking about some of the different techniques and strategies that you need to utilize in investment accounts, but it's really following what the big money is doing, the smart money, the banks. They are projecting what they're doing. Where we find that is on a price chart. That's telling you exactly what's happening, but you need a rules-based strategy for making your investment decisions. And as I said it towards the end of the segment, it's not about quantity of trades, it's about quality of trades. If you happen to miss two tickets for the investing class, call 952-814-4410, or you can also text the word INVEST to the number 484848. You're going to receive a text back with a link. You got to click that link. When you register for that class and attend, you're going to get our free cryptocurrency course. So, Al, as you want to get into this, to this next topic about strategy, right? There's most investors that are probably listening right now don't really have an actual investment strategy. More of just a buy somewhere in the market, something in the market, and hope it goes up, right? Now, there's some things that you've helped a lot of people do in their strategies, but there's things that you see common that they need to add to their strategy, maybe to have a better potential or higher potential of success. What are some of those things that you might see somebody needing to add? And then how do we utilize that in a strategy and then follow that consistently?
Well, most people, when they have a portfolio put together, you go to an advisor or a broker or an advisor, and basically what they're going to say is, yeah, we need to get you in the market. It's time in the market. It's not timing the market. We're saying the exact opposite. It's timing the market. So they really don't pay attention necessarily to price right now. We think that, that's the most important thing, is to be able to identify the right price. And the way you do that is to read a chart and identify what the smart money is showing us. I mean, think about it. If you got people out there like the hedge funds, the big investment firms, people like Warren Buffett, that are successful on a consistent basis, wouldn't it be smart to follow what they're doing, just to kind of copy what they're doing because they're doing something right? And that's really what the core strategy is designed to do. But it is that price that is so important. The proper entry, the precise entry point, is important, because without it, and this is how most retail traders or the public trades, they take on too much risk with reduced reward. And I'm teaching a class this coming Saturday, and also on Wednesday.
Yep.
And if you come into the class, I'm going to show you. I'll show you how that is and how there's a direct relationship between your control of risk and the amount of profit potential you can have. It's very important. And the precise entry points, what they're going to tell you is where you have the opportunity of being right, where that's the strongest, and then it's going to tell you where and when and how much you can be wrong if you're wrong. And that's the one you want to control because of that relationship. So anyways, we'll go over that in these classes. And at the end of that last segment, I said there's some things you need to add to the core strategy to give you an opportunity to be successful. One is understanding that the market doesn't just go one direction. Most of you are in a position that will only benefit if the market goes up. But what if it doesn't? What if it goes down? What if it goes sideways? How are you positioned to take advantage of that? And if not, wouldn't it be important to do that? Because that's what the smart money does. They don't care which direction the market is going, because they know there are opportunities in all three directions. So should you know how to do that? Absolutely. You should know how to participate, and don't limit your opportunities, because when the market goes down, when we see a correction or a bear market, not everybody is losing. There's a large number of people that actually do better in those market conditions. We don't look at that as being a bad thing. It's just a different opportunity, or an opportunity in a different direction.
To give an example of that, so let's just say the market goes up 100%, goes back down 100%, and goes back up 100%. Someone that bought at the very bottom and just held it has a 100% return, right? But if the price goes up 100%, goes down 100%, there's an opportunity 100% on the way down, and then an opportunity back on the way up. So there's a 300% potential there. So that's where you need to have a strategy for all conditions.
Well, yeah, and if you're letting money be taken away from you, let's just say that we go through a 50% reduction in the market. You don't have to be up 50% to get back to where you were. You have to be up 100%.
Exactly.
And that's where you're making your portfolio work harder just to get back to where you were. So protection is a huge part of it. That's where that control of risk management is so important. But also, why not participate if the market is providing these opportunities for you in different directions? Why not be able to take advantage of it? And that's what our students learn how to do. It's understanding that there are always opportunities as long as the market is open. But if you use that core strategy, that's going to help you identify the right entry price, the right exit price. And those are huge. Those are very important to you having the opportunity to be successful and be consistent in your trading. The other thing is to understand what the proper asset is for you. Are you looking more at the short term for your financial needs? Are you looking at long term? Because there are different ways of approaching each. There's different strategies and different assets that are available. And also, where are you? What kind of a position are you in financially? Because it's dangerous to make decisions on million-dollar portfolios with the financial intelligence that's appropriate for a $1,000 portfolio. That's where the education comes in. The education, the knowledge that you get, the financial intelligence should grow with the value of your assets. That's why there's no cookie-cutter kind of access to education. The education should be ongoing. It should be something that grows as you grow, and it should cover all of the different assets because what's appropriate for one person as a trader investment might be totally inappropriate for somebody else.
Yeah, I get really excited talking about this part, especially right here when we have opportunities in up markets and huge opportunities in down markets, because I love it. The market goes down much faster. So you have these opportunities that have the potential to move faster. Okay, that's less activity, right? That's common knowledge, right? So with these opportunities, you have to learn how to do that, but you have to have the right tools, understanding how to get in at the right price, how to get out at the right price, and then have the proper asset to utilize. If you want to learn more about that, as Al was talking about, he's teaching a couple classes coming up this week. Text the word invest to the number 484848 for two tickets for this investing class. I know you text in. You have to click the link that we're going to text you back. That will pick a date for you. Actually, I should say you will pick a date in there, and then when you come in, you're going to receive the free cryptocurrency course. So, Al, you mentioned a couple things. You needed to have the proper price, where to get in your positions, where to get out of your positions. You also need the proper asset. You were talking about there's two types of investing. You have short-term and you have long-term investing, right?
Correct.
So let's talk about, I know in the next segment we'll talk a little bit more about the long-term, but let's talk about that short-term process, right? Short-term investing, we'll consider that income potential trading, trading for income potential.
Right.
Now, explain a little bit more on how that would be utilized to our listeners. Let's just say they work during the day and they want to have income potential or like an extra income, because if you think about it, that's what fills your long-term wealth bucket.
Right.
So talk about that a little bit.
Yeah, I think it's really important to accept the fact that you need to understand how to generate that short-term income before you can really build the wealth part, the what you're going to rely on down the road. And for most of you, if you're still working, your bills are paid, the fun that you're having, that car that you're driving, that comes from money from your income. Well, that might, all those things I just mentioned, might take all of your income, and then you have very little, if anything, left over to kind of fund that account for down the road, the wealth account, the retirement accounts that you have. So it's important to understand how to access the markets just like the institutions do. All we're doing is we're showing you how to access short-term trading for income potential just like the institutions are doing, the same things that they're doing. The ironic thing is that you as their clients are being put into something that's only a long-term portfolio. And some people might say, well, that's your wealth building. Not really. When you go to a financial advisor, what you're doing is you're bringing in most cases, the wealth you've already accumulated, and then they're putting it into something. They're selling you a product to put that wealth into. How do you get that wealth? For a lot of you, maybe you're not at that point yet, and you need to do something to be able to reach that point. And that's where generating short-term trades, that again, like the institutions are doing, that can be a goal or a choice or a, uh, I, I guess a, yeah, choice that some people make. They look at the financial markets for that. Some people will get a second or third job. Some people might look at real estate. And there's a lot of our students that looked at those things and looked and said, you know what, I want to look at the financial markets because there are so many benefits there. And being able to access strategies and assets that can benefit you in the different market conditions becomes really important. If you're short term, that's your goal, then there are certain assets and strategies that are appropriate for that.
Yeah.
And then if you're looking more the long term down the road, there's different ways of investing for that long term portfolio, but you need to really know both.
Yeah, I as you know, I was saying earlier, I get excited talking about the financial markets with opportunities and up and down markets, but also with these other assets, right? So you talked a little bit about some of the perks on why you need these assets. Let's get into a little more detail. And I know you talk more about these in the investing class, sure. But with stocks at all-time highs, it's hard for average investors to buy and hold.
Correct.
There's only so much further they can go, right? But you need a strategy for shorter-term trading right now. And futures and Forex is options are those main key ones there. But would you say, is there any one of those that's better than another, or do they all have the same opportunities?
They all have great opportunities, but again, as I mentioned earlier, there are things that are appropriate for different people. So those are the things that we kind of help you with. If you're looking for very short-term opportunities, maybe futures is the best asset for you. If you're looking for something that can be utilized in different market time conditions and utilized in retirement accounts, maybe options would be the way for you to go. If you're looking at short-term and long-term, Forex, the foreign exchange market, is great. And that actually is a market that probably every person listening, including your grandma, has been involved in.
I would guess if they have a dollar, you are in a currency trade.
Absolutely. If you've done any traveling and you've exchanged dollars for pesos, for example, or whatever the monetary asset is in that particular country, you are involved in the Forex market, the foreign exchange market. But what happens to the dollar is very important to us. And
what's been happening in the past 30, 40, 50 years?
Yeah, with the value of the dollar has gone down significantly. Well, you hedge that maybe by having access to some other currencies, some foreign currencies, mm-hmm. that can hedge that. There's a number of different things that you can do, but one of the things that we do is help you identify what might be the most appropriate asset for you based on what your goals are, what your expectations are, and also kind of what your personality is.
Yeah, I like that with, the currency market especially. And just to clarify, too, you don't have to go to another country to purchase their currency. It's all done on a platform, just like if you buy a stock, it's all done on the computer. And I think the key thing that you just touched right at the end there is your strategy is based off your personality, too.
Right.
We talk with people all the time. Some people say, I don't want to be a day trader. Well, day trading is kind of a thing of the past, so we're not talking day trading. Say you like to be a currency trader and you want to trade longer-term positions. A lot of people that love the currency market for that. Same thing with options. People like to be in longer-term positions, so they feel it's maybe less stress. So these are some different terms we might be talking about. They're not new. They're just a little bit different. And when you explain it, it really helps people build the confidence and build some consistency in their investment decisions. You help people with that in these investing classes. You dive into what the futures market is, what the Forex market is, options, how it might be traded, the leverage that is allowed there.
Right.
As you can tell, I'm getting excited again. You're talking about some great opportunities for people, and I think a lot of our listeners are missing out on that.
Yep.
So you got to come into one of these investing classes that Al teaches. He teaches several per week. We have these on the weekends. We also do these during the week. They're only 2 hours. They're free. You can call 952-814-4410 for two tickets for the investing class. I'm also going to give away the financial quick start kit here. So when you attend the investing class, you get the financial quick start kit. That will help you get started right away. 952-814-4410 or text the word invest to the number 484848. You receive a link back. Click the link when you get that text. Pick a date for the investing class to come and see Al, and you'll get two tickets plus the financial quick start kit. Al, what's next?
Well, you know what? Let's talk about why a mirror might be the best tool to help you realize your retirement goals.
Well, I was talking about getting excited. Now I'm really talking about a mirror. Getting excited in mirror investing and trading. Once again, for two tickets, 952-814-4410. This is Josh and Al, Investing with Confidence. We'll be right back.
(Clears throat)